In this chapter, we will read about the new kings and kingdoms during the period of 7th to 12th century. So, in this period, what was the change? The change was the emergence of new kings and kingdoms. Emergence means, yes, the rise of the new kings and kingdoms. But what they were earlier? Yes, they were the Samantas. Those who arrived or those who develop their powers and become the powerful ruler. In this chapter, we will also read about some powerful dynasties. These are the Gujjaras and Pratiharas, the Palas, the Rashtrakutas and the Chauhanas. All these dynasties were powerful at their time and they developed their empire. They increased the boundaries of their empire, and in this time there was the continuous struggle that was also known as a tripartite struggle. It was the struggle for the fertile area of Kannauj. All the dynasties want to take control over Kannauj. That's why they were fighting with each other. Kannauj was the fertile area. It was lying in the Ganga fertile areas, and all the dynasties want to have control over it. That's why they were having the struggle among them for the fertile area of Kannauj. We will read about the dynasties. The first dynasty was the Gujjar Pratiharas. Nagabhatta, the famous ruler, was the founder of this dynasty, and Vatsaraja and Bhoja, they were also the famous ruler of this dynasty. Mihir Bhoja, one of the famous ruler of this dynasty, established the large empire, and he established that empire in the northern side. He made his capital Kannauj, and he was the follower of Lord Vishnu. As he was the follower of Lord Vishnu, that's why he was called as Adivaraha. He was the supporter of the literature, and the famous Sanskrit poet named Rajashekhara was the poet in his court. Then we will read about the Palas. Palas, the rule of Palas was around 750 CE. Gopala was the founder of this Pala dynasty, and he conquered Bengal, Bihar and some parts of Odisha and Nepal. After all that, Dharampala and Devpala extended their empire, and they concluded the Kannauj and Assam. Then they were the patron of Buddhism, and they given a lot of donations to the Nalanda University, as the study of Buddhism was done, that we have done already in class 6th. Then Dharampala also founded the Dharamshila Buddhist University. And then Mahipala was defeated by the Rajendra Chola. And in this dynasty, Rampala was the famous or known ruler. Then this dynasty was declined due to the Khilji invasions. Dynasty is the Rashtrakuta dynasty, and they ruled from 793 to 968 CE. Then Govinda III, Amoghvarsha and Krishna III, they were the famous ruler of this dynasty. This dynasty was established by Dhanti Durga. Means Dhanti Durga was the founder of this dynasty. Rashtrakuta. Rashtrakuta means Rashtra, and Kuta means territory. Rashtra means territory and Kuta means the chieftains. Means they were the Samantas or chief of the Chalukyan dynasty. Then their capital was Malkhand or the Manyaket. This dynasty was a dynasty who ruled near about 200 years. The rock cut painting, which are very famous nowadays too, Ajanta Ellora caves or the Elephanta caves in Maharashtra, were made during this dynasty.
The next dynasty is the Chauhanas, Chahamanas. This is the famous dynasty of Ajmer. Then they were the vassals of Gujjar Pratiharas, means they were the Samantas of Gujjar Pratiharas. Prithviraj Chauhan, this is a very famous, worldwide famous, you can say, name, and he was the famous ruler of this dynasty. In 1177 CE, he ascended the throne and he fought two very famous battles. These are known as the Battle of Tarain. First Battle of Tarain was fought in 1191 CE and Second Battle of Tarain was fought in 1192 CE. These battles were fought between Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori. This is the half explanation of the chapter. Along with this, I am giving you some question answers that you have to complete in your notebook. Half explanation and rest of the questions I will give you in the next period. Thank you.